हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सारस्वत इंटरनेशनल एकेडमी। दिस इज द सिक्स्थ वीडियो ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 10 मैथमेटिक्स एंड द चैप्टर नंबर इज थर्ड पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल। इन अ प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द एल्जेब्रिक मेथड नंबर वन विच इज सब्स्टिट्यूशन मेथड फॉर सॉल्विंग द पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न द सेकेंड एल्जेब्रिक मेथड फॉर सॉल्विंग अ पेयर ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन। So let's start the video. Now the second method is elimination method. So how you can solve a pair of linear equation by using this method? So let's take one example for that. So we will consider another exam method for elimination on one variable. For one variable elimination method, we will consider one example, that example number 11. That the ratio of the incomes of two persons is 9:7 and the ratio of the expense or expenditure is 4:3. If each of them manage to save rupees 2000 per month, then find their monthly income. So we have to find the monthly income of two persons. So for solving, first of all we have to solve the ratios. So assuming let denote the incomes of two persons is rupees 9x and rupees 7x, and let the ratio of their expenditure or their expenditure by rupees 4y and 3y respectively. So we are taking x with the income and y for the expenditure. So now we have the relation. What is our saving? Our saving is 2000 rupees one. So how we will save the income? So my saving is become income minus expenditure. That will become my saving. So how much amount we have saved from the income, which is become your saving. So income minus expenditure will become your saving. So now for the first person, income is 9x and expenditure is 4y. So my first equation will become 9x minus 4y. Again it will become 2000 because each person has saving rupees 2000. And that is my first equation. Now the second equation, the income of the second person is 7x and its expenditure is 3y. So we can say 7x minus 3y is equal to 2000, and that is my second equation. So now we have to solve this equation by elimination method. In elimination method, we have to eliminate one variable from the equation. So what I am doing? I am doing three steps for doing that. So in step one, I am multiplying the equation 1 by 3 and equation 2 by 4 to make the coefficient of y equal. Then we get the equations. So what I am doing, I am multiplying the equation number 1 by 3 and the second equation by 4 to make the coefficient of y numerically equal. So my first equation will become 27x minus 12y equals to 6000, which is my third equation which I have derived. And the fourth equation will become 28x minus 12y is equals to 8000, which is my fourth equation. Now, in this case, we have to add or subtract the both equation, third number and fourth number. But how we can know what we have to do? So, first of all, check whether the coefficients are equal or not. Whenever the coefficients are equal, then check the sign is equal or not. So here we can say the both sign has negative for coefficient of y. So in this case you have to subtract this equation. If there is plus 12 on both side, both equation, then also you have to subtract that equation. But you have the different sign, or plus 12 or minus 12, then you have to add this equation. So in this case we have the both coefficients are equal in sign also. So in this case, step number 2, subtracting equation number 3 from equation number 4 to eliminate y. Now, why? Because they are coefficients of the y are equal. That's why I am eliminating y. If you are making coefficient of x equal, then you have to eliminate the variable x. So subtracting equation. So my equation will become 28x minus 12, 27x minus 12y minus 12y is equals to 8000 minus 6000. So what I am subtracting? 27x minus 20x subtracting from the variable x and y subtracting from variable y. So now 28 minus 27 will become x, 12y minus 12y will become 0. So my equation will become x is equals to 2000. So this is my value of x. Now, what you have to do? Step number three, substituting this value in first or second equation. So I am substituting this equation in first one. You can also substitute this value in second equation also, but not into third and fourth. So I am substituting the value of x in equation number one. So I will get 9 into 2000 minus 4y equals to 2000. So I will get y is equals to 4000 after simplifying these values. So what we get? The solution of the equation is x is equals to 2000 and y is equals to 4000. Now, x denoted for the income of the persons and y denoted the expenditure of the functions. Question, but we have to find income of the person, which is 9x and 7x. So we can say the monthly income of the persons are first 9 into 2000, which become 18,000, and second is 7 into 2000, which has become 14,000. So incomes of the persons are 18,000 and 14,000. If you are asking about the expenditure, then you have to take the second ratio and put the value of y in there, and you will get the income of that person also. So this is the step you have to follow. So which step you have to follow where eliminating this variable? So we will follow the following steps. So you have to remember, let us not note that how you can follow the steps to elimination method. Which step you have to follow to eliminate one variable or find a solution using elimination method? So step number one, first multiply the both equations by some suitable non-zero number or constant to make the coefficients of one variable, either x or either y, equal, numerically equal. First of all, you have, I say, make numerically equal value. Now step number two, then add or subtract one equation from the other equation so that one variable gets eliminated. So we have to add or subtract the equation. If you get the equation in one variable, now what will happen? If you get only one variable left in the equation, you have to go for the step number three. But not happening then. In some cases, both variables will get eliminated in the second step. So what you have to do, then you have to check these two values. First case, in step 2, we obtain a true statement involving no variable. What will happen? Eliminating variable will be eliminated on both sides, and you will get 0 equals to 0, 2 equals to 2, 3 equals to 3. Then you can say the involving value are equal, so statements are mathematically true. So in this case, you will get the original pair of linear equations has infinitely many solutions for the true statements. Like I have said that 0 equals to 0, 2 equals to 2, 5 equals to 5 in this kind of value, which have not involving any variable x or y. But it is not happening. You will get 3 equals to 0, 5 equals to 0, which are not non-zero or non-true statements or false statements. So if in the step 2, we obtain the false statement like 2 equals to 0, 3 equals to 0, again involving no variable, there is no variable in the remaining values, then the equations or original pair of linear equation has no solution because they are inconsistent or parallel lines. That's why it will have no solutions. Now the next third step which you have to follow, we have discussed in the step 1, if you get the equation in one variable, then you have to go to the step 3. Now, what is the step 3? Step 3, that solve the equation in one variable that you will find the value of x or y to get its value. So, we have to find the value of x or y from step number 3. And what you have to do in the last step? So, in the step number 4, substitute this value for x or y in either of the original equations. So, first or second equation, you have to put the values of x or y which you have obtained from step 3. So you will get the solution of the second variable also, and in this way you can find any values of x and y for the given pair of linear equation. So again consider one example to understand this method. Now I am considering example number 12. Use elimination method to find all possible solutions for the following pair of linear equations, which are 2x plus 3y equals to 8 and 4x plus 6y equals to 7. Now, next example is example number 13. The sum of two-digit number and the number obtained by reversing the digits is 66. If the digits of the number differ by 2, then find the numbers. How many such numbers are there? So we have to find the number first of all, and then we have to also find how many numbers will satisfy the following conditions. So first of all, we have to create the linear equation two variable, and then we have to solve it. So first of all, assuming what is a two digit number. Again, we know two digit number has two places, unit place and tenth place. So let assuming the tenth place and the unit digits in the first number be x and y. So I can say the first number may be written as 10x plus y in the exponent form. Now, why I am writing 10x plus y? So let us consider one example. If I have to write 56, so I can say it is 50 plus 6. 50 can be written as 10 into 5 plus 6. So what now we can see here, 5 is a 10th place digit and 6 is a unit place digit. So we can expand in the two digit form like 10x plus y form, where x is a 10th place digit and y is a unit place digit. Now, when the digits are reversed, what will be happen when digits? So x becomes the unit place digit and y becomes the 10th place digit. So this number can be written as 10y plus x. Now, why it has become 10 plus x? So for example, when 56 is reversed, it can be written as 65. So it can be written as 10 into 6 plus 5. Again, 6 is a unit place 10 place digit and 5 is a unit place digit. So this way we can find the number obtaining by reversing the digits. Now what will be happen? According to the given condition, sum of the numbers, sum of both numbers 10x plus y and 10y plus x is 66. So I can get the first equation. It is 10x plus y plus 10y plus x is equals to 66. So I will get 11x plus 11y equals to 66. 11 taking common from the both equation, I will get 11 into x plus y is equals to 66. Now, dividing by 11 on both sides, I will get x plus y is equals to 6, and that is my first equation. Now, for the second condition, what we have? Second condition we have that given that the digits differ by 2. Therefore, now digits differ by 2, so difference between two digits are 2, but which digits? Unit place, 10th place or 10th place unit place? So here two conditions are occurring. The first condition can be x minus y should be 2 or y minus x can be 2. So let first equation x minus y equals to 2 will become my second equation, and y minus x equals to 2 become my third equation. Now, if x minus y equals to 2, we are considering the first equation, then solving first and second equation by elimination method. So first of all, I am writing the first equation, which is x plus y equals to 6, and the second equation, which is x minus y equals to 2. Now, what will happen here? You can say coefficient of x and coefficient of y are numerically equal, where both are 1. So you can add or subtract both equation. If we have to eliminate x, we have to subtract this equation. But if we have to eliminate y, we have to add this equation because they have different signs. So here we can add the equation. So by adding both equation, yy will be eliminated because plus y minus y will be eliminated. So now in the equation of right and left hand side, I will get x plus x, which has become 2x. And in right hand side, it will become 6 plus 2, which is equals to 8. So here you can find x is equals to 4. Now what you have to do? Put the value of x in equation number 1. So you will get 4 plus y is equals to 6. So you, after solving, you will get y is equals to 6 minus 4, which has become 2. So in this case, we get the number x is equals to 4 and y is equals to 2. So what is my number? Then the two digit number will be 10x plus y. So put the value of x and y. So I will get 10 into 4 plus 2, which is 40 plus 2, which is equals to 42. So my first two digit number will be 42. If I am taking the third equation, if y minus x equals to 2, and again solving the first and third equation, so again by similar method, you can solve it and you will get x is equals to 2 and y is equals to 4. So what you have to do in this case, we get the number which is 20 plus 4, which is equals to 24. Again, you can put the x and y in the 10x plus y and you will get the number 24. So there are two numbers, 42 and 24, which are considering this equation. So there are the numbers are 42 and 24, and there are two numbers which satisfy the following conditions. Now the next one. Now, exercise number 3.4. Now, we have to discuss the exercise 3.4. Now, the first question is, solve the following pair of linear equations by the elimination method and the substitution method. So, we have to do with both method, elimination method and substitution method. So, how we can do it? Let the first case. The first equation is x plus y is equals to 5 and 2x minus 3y is equals to 4. Now, the first method, elimination method, we have to use two methods, elimination method, which we have learned in this video, and the substitution method, which we have learned in a previous video. So now from the elimination method, let us assume x plus y is equals to 5 and this is my first equation, and 2x minus 3y is equals to 4 will be my second equation. Now, what we have to do? Multiply the first equation by 2 and subtracting from the equation number 2. Why I am doing this? I am making coefficient of x equal, which is 2. So now the third equation will become 2x plus 3y minus 3y is equals to 4, the second equation. And the first equation, which I am multiplying by 2, it will become 2x plus 2y is equals to 10. Now, subtracting equation number 2, so I have to change the signs for the all values. Now, solving 2x will be eliminated, minus 3y minus 2y. Now, the sign is changed here because we have changed the sign for the elimination. So, it will become minus 3x minus 3y minus 2y. So, I will get minus 5y. Now, 4 minus 10 will become minus 6. So, y is equals to 6 by 5. That is my value of y. Now, for the value of x, put the value of y in equation number 1 or equation number 2. So, I am putting in equation number 1. So, I will get x plus 6 by 5 equals to 5. So, I will get x is equals to 5 minus 6 by 5, which is equals to 19 by 5. 25 minus 6 will become 19 by 5. So, hence you can say x is equals to 19 by 5. So, my solutions, x is equals to 19 by 5 and y is equals to 6 by 5. So this is the method of elimination. Now we will solve this question by substitution method. So the substitution method, In substitution method, let again considering the x plus y is equals to 5 is my first equation, and 2x plus minus 3y equals to 4 will be my second equation. Now, again from the equation number 1, what I am obtaining? Y is equals to 5 minus x. I am taking y as the left hand side and x towards right hand side. So this is my third equation. Now put the value of y in equation number 2. So we get 2x minus 3 into 5 minus x is equals to 4. So I will get 2x minus 15 plus 3x equals to 4. So I will get 5x is equals to 19. So I will get x is equals to 19 by 5. Now for the value of y, put the value of x in equation number 3. So I will get y is equals to 5 minus 19 by 5. Again 25 minus 19 by 5. Again it will become 6 by 5. So hence again you will find x is equals to 19 by 5 and y is equals to 6 by 5. So you have seen that from both method we will get the same answer. So you can use any method in the examination, by elimination method or by substitution method or another method we will learn in the previous next video. Now the second question for the first that one. Now in this following questions I will solve the all questions by elimination method, but you have to solve it by substitution method and that will become your homework. So now the second question, 3x plus 4y equals to 10 and 2x minus 2y is equals to 2. Now for that one, 3x plus 4y equals to 10 will become my first equation and 2x minus 2y is equals to 2 will become my second equation. Now what I am doing, I am multiplying the equation number 2 by 2 and adding with the first equation. Why I am doing this? I am making the coefficient of y equal towards the, because it is a 4 in the first equation, so from the second equation I am making the coefficient 4. So after that my third equation will be 3x plus 4y equals to 10, that is my third equation, and the next equation will become 4x minus 4y equals to 4. Now what I have to do, first of all we have to check the numerically value are equal. Now the signs are different, first is plus 4 and next is minus 4. So that we have to add this equation. So I will get 7x, 4y will be eliminated, and then the right hand side I will get 14. So x is equals to 14 by 7, which is equals to 2. Now put the value of x in any of them. So I am putting the value of x in equation number 1. So I will get 3 into 2 plus 4y equals to 10. So I will get 6 is 4y is equals to 10 minus 6, which is equals to 4. So therefore y is equals to 1. Hence the solutions are x is equals to 2 and y is equals to 1. So this is the elimination method. You have to solve this question by substitution method also as your homework. Now a third question of the exercise, 3x minus 5y minus 4 equals to 0 and 9x plus 2y equals to 9x equals to 2y plus 7, this is my second equation. So let first equation will be 3x minus 4y minus 4 equals to 0, this is my first equation, and the second is 9x minus 2y equals to 7, this is my second equation. Now I am making coefficient of x equal, so multiplying the equation 1 by 3 and subtracting from the equation number 2. Now why I am multiplying the only one equation? First of all, check whether you have to multiply only one equation such that any one variable will become equal. If not happening, then you have to multiply the both equation by any two different number. So in this equation, just we have to multiply the first equation such that the variable x will become same coefficients. That's why I am multiplying the first equation. So after 9x minus 2y is equal to 7 will become my first equation, and 9x minus 15y is equals to 12 will become my fourth equation. Now subtracting this equation, so I am changing the sign of the all points. If you have to subtract, then you have to change the sign of the all points of the second equation, but if you are not doing adding them, then you have to not change the sign of any equation. So now it will become 9x will be eliminated, minus 2 plus 15y will become 13y, and 7 minus 12 will become minus 5. So y is equals to minus 5 by 13. Now again putting the value of y in equation number 1 or 2, so I am putting in equation number 2. So I will get 9x minus 2 into minus 5 by 13 is equals to 7. Now 2 will minus 2 will multiply by 5y, it will become plus 10 by 13. So taking that value towards second side, I will get 9x is equals to 7 minus 10 by 13. It will still become 81 by 13. So x will become 9 by 13. So hence solutions are x is equals to 9 by 13 and y is equals to minus 5 by 13. Now the fourth one. The fourth question is x by 2 plus 2y by 3 equals to minus 1 and x minus y by 3 equals to 3. First of all, you have to simplify the equation to getting easy values. So taking LCM 6 from the first equation, my first equation will become 3x plus 4y is equals to minus 6. And the second, that will become my first equation, and the second will become 3x minus y is equals to 9 will become my second equation. So here you don't have to multiply anything because you know, you can see here the coefficient of x are already numerically equal. So just subtract the equation number 1 from equation number 2. So I will get 3x plus 4y is equals to minus 6, which is my third equation, first equation, and 3x minus y is equal to, now we have to subtracting, then we have to change the sign for the second equation. So the next equation will become minus, the second sign will become plus, and the third sign will become again minus. So I will get 3x, 3x will be eliminated. Now my plus 4y and plus 5y will become 5y, and it will become minus 15. So here y is equals to minus 3. Now put this value in any of one of first or second equation. So putting the value of y in equation number 1, I will get 3x plus 4 into minus 3 is equals to minus 6. So I will get 3x is equals to minus 6 plus 6. Therefore x is equals to 2. So hence again you can say solutions are x is equals to 2 and y is equals to minus 3. So this is the method you can find the solution of pair of linear equation by elimination method. In next video we will discuss the word problem for the same method in the continue exercise. Thank you.